My name is Vijaya. Now, I would like to say something about Veena. The Veena is an instrument which is shown being played by goddess herself. Vanyate iti Veena. That means, which creates sound is called Veena. This is the etymological interpretation of the Sanskrit word Veena. Hanini, the great grammarian, has explained the word Vana as meaning sound. Significantly, Vedic literature often finds the word Vana being used in the meaning of Veena. Veena Vadana Tattvajnaha Sruti Jati Visaradaha Talajnasya Aprayasena Mokshamadam Chagarchati. Means, who knows playing the mystery of Veena and is adept in Sruti and has a sound knowledge of Laya, effortlessly finds on the way to Moksha. Veena is the only instrument shows the difference between Swaram and Sahaja. In Veena, main parts are Yali. This is Yali. Kunda. This is Kunda. Dandi. This is Dandi. Dandi. This is Kumba. And 24 frets. These are 24 frets. This is bed of wax. Bridge. This is bridge. These are the langars. Main strings, four. These are the main strings. And tala strings, three. Tuning beads. These are the tuning beads. These are the tuning beads. And white buttons. These are the white buttons. This indicates the sarasanas. These are the main parts of the Veena. The four strings depict the four Vedas. Namely, Sarni signifies Rig Veda, Panchamam which signifies Yajur Veda, Mandramam which signifies Adharman Veda, Sama Veda, and Anumandram which signifies Adharman Veda. All the four strings are said to have Sudha Sattaguna. The first string, Sarni, signifies Jnana Sakti. The second string, Panchamam, signifies Ichha Sakti, Kriya Sakti. And the third string, Mandram, signifies Ichha Sakti. And the fourth string, called Anumandram, also signifies Ichha Sakti. The importance of the 24 threads comes from the sound produced from them and not merely by the physical presence of the inmate metal frets. Hence, the 24 frets of different pitches of sound covering the two octaves depict the Gayatri mantra with the 24 letters. Tatsarutir Varenyam Bhargo Devasidevahi Diyo Yona Prajo. Now, the significance for the three Tala strings. Nada has got the three aspects of Srishti, Sthiti and Laya, that is creation, protection and destruction. Just as the universe has these three aspects, the three Tala strings symbolize these three universal actions. The Veena has also been compared to the human body. The spinal cord in the human body is held throughout the length of the body right from the anus point to the top of the head, called Brahmarantra. It is divided into 24 vertebrae as the 24 frets of Veena. Now, I will give you a small description on Veena and also how to play. Veena brings out raga, tala. Addition to these two dimensions, other dimensions there. Kunda is the main resonator connected with a 4 feet long stem or dandi made up of jackfruit root, very seasonal fruit, helps the fine grains to absorb music. All the resonance will actually inside the wood, plucking the strings produces a very good sound. A small gourd is used to supportive thing to the player. This helps to the small gourd player to keep on the left thigh like this. Keep on the left thigh and the left hand brought below the stem like this. Below the stem or dandi. And the hand brought over the frets in a curve fashion like this. So that it is keeping the fingers and the frets, index and middle, these two fingers we have to use. Index and middle on the frets and the palm of the right hand. This one. Like this. Palm of the right hand. Like this. At the edge of plant. And for plucking, we have to use index and middle fingers. This is also made up of jackfruit root, and the two fingers, index and middle fingers, which are used to pluck all the strings with the right hand. One end of the strings bound nearer to bridge and the other end of strings connect with wooden pegs. Wooden pegs are measured. These are wooden pegs. Wooden pegs are used for major adjustments in Srutis. And for minor adjustments, small beads beyond the bridge are used for minor adjustments. Moving to right, that is down, increase the sound. Moving left, that is up, decrease the sound. Using wooden pegs, tighten the string, high pitch will be produced, and looser the string, low pitch will be produced. Now, I will come to the plucking part of the main strings played by index and middle fingers in downward direction. Like this. In downward direction, and tala strings played by the little finger in upward direction, and supposed to happen simultaneously. Tala strings and main string whenever the beat comes, that is the beginning of lagu and beginning of dhruva. It is very important to play alternate fingers, that is index and middle, should not go down. We should stop halfway. All the thala strings played together. Coming to the tuning, first string is tuned to Adhar Shajjam, that is Madhyasthayi Shajjam. Second string is tuned to Mandrasthayi Panchami. Third string is tuned to Mandrasthayi Shajjamam. Fourth string is tuned to Anumandrasthayi Panchami. While playing Veena, we use Gamakas. It gives beauty where the Gamakam requires, like ornamentation. The strings of the Veena are pulled to produce maybe the next two swaras. If we extend beyond that, it goes against the nature of the instrument. Here we had to follow Vajanam. For example, in Gandharam, we should pull up to Panchami. That is, like that. Up to 3 swaras. The Veena produces a beautiful and enigmatic sound that is often used to relax the mind and help in meditation. Names of some of the Veenas believed to have been played by celestial beings from ancient Vedic times. Goddess Saraswati Kachapi, Lord Shiva Rudra Veena, Lord Brahma Brahmaveena, Narada Mahati, Ravana Ravana. The ancient treatises promised the four Purusharthas for the Veena player, Dharma, in the return for offering Veena music during sacrifices like Aswamedha and Rajasuya. The Veena player gets to do a lot of Dharma. Artha, by playing Veena, the player earns a lot of wealth, Kama. His lust is satiated with the women who fall for his music. Moksha. As per Yajnavalkya's declaration, playing Veena is the easiest path to Moksha.